Good afternoon. Investigators are now going over radio tape recordings to try to figure out what happened this weekend in the River Thames when two boats crashed into each other. It appears the captains of the two vessels were arguing over who had the right of way. Meantime, officials fear the death toll from the tragedy could go as high as 60. Hal Walker has details.
Recovery workers have brought up the hull of the pleasure boat Marchioness and towed it to the riverbank. But investigators say it may be days, if not weeks, before the full toll of the Thames River collision is known. First of all, they simply don't know how many people were on board. It could have been 110 or up to 150. The captain of this party craft, who would have counted the passengers, is among those missing after his boat was rammed by the 2,000-ton barge Bow Bell early Sunday morning. Police and rescue workers were on the scene within minutes of the accident and pulled survivors from the muddy waters of the Thames. But the pleasure boat, according to witnesses, sank like a stone.
I dived out the window, so there were lots of the people downstairs. I don't know, I mean, there's no way they would have got out.
It was 16 hours after the accident that salvage operations raised a part of the sunken vessel and recovered some of the bodies, mostly those trapped on the dance floor below decks. While investigators sift through the evidence, authorities have reopened the Thames for business as usual. But others are saying that the accident proves the need for stricter regulation of this crowded waterway. Hal Walker, ABC News, London.
Back at home, contaminated soil is finally being removed from Beaver Dam Flats 2 years after it was first discovered. Work started yesterday, much to the relief of area residents.
Twice in the last 2 weeks, the old sewage treatment plant in Banff has failed, sending massive amounts of untreated human waste into the Bow River. As a result, the river has been closed to the public from Banff south to Lac des Arcs until at least mid-September. Environment Minister Ralph Klein says if that had been a private company, they would be charged and fined heavily under the Clean Water Act.
Unfortunately, one government can't charge, or a government can't charge a senior government. Now, we could be charged by the federal government, but unfortunately, nothing exists where we can go in and charge the federal government, although they're polluting our waterways. So I think it's this kind of jurisdictional situation that's going to have to be straightened out.
The minister will fire off a letter this week detailing for Ottawa just how much damage these sewage spills have had on the river, but also demanding Alberta be given powers to monitor all projects affecting the environment on federal land, just like the feds have been demanding with the Alberta pulp and paper mill developments.
Well, that, of course, was the story from the sewage treatment plant in Banff, which is now leaking partially treated sewage into the Bow River. We'll be back at 6 o'clock with news, weather, and sports. Join us then.